Hi, I am Rahul Kokcha. I welcome all to the one of the most interesting topic in the world of information security, the cryptography. Cryptography has its role in all five fields of information security: the confidentiality, as it provides encryption; integrity, the hash functions can determine the modifications; authenticity, digital signatures can verify the source of the information; availability, the certificates can be used for authentication; and non-repudiation, the digital signed messages cannot be denied. In today's webinar, we will discuss about symmetric encryption, asymmetric encryption, secure socket layer or SSL, hash functions, and digital signatures. Okay, let us start. What is this? This is encrypted text. You can see some characters but cannot understand it. What I have written is secure. How I did it? I applied a simple logic of plus 1. What comes after this is T, and what comes after E is F, and after C is D, and so on. So plus is a logic which is called algorithm in terms of cryptography, and one is the factor by which the logic is applied. This is called key in terms of cryptography. Now let's take an example. Let us say there are three users, A, B, and C. A wants to communicate with B and C, and let us say it uses plus 1 for both communications. Now in this case, B and C can understand the messages being sent by A to each other. So even if the logic is or algorithm is same, we should use a different key. For example, A can use plus 1 for B and plus 5 for C to keep the information secret among B and C. But how A and B will start using encryption? Let us say A uses plus 5 to encrypt the message and sends to B. But how B will decrypt it? B should know the same algorithm and the key to decrypt the message. Remember, algorithm is not a secret. We all know how DES, triple DES, AES and other encryption algorithm works. So the secret lies in the key. To start using encryption, A and B need to negotiate a common algorithm and the key. Once the algorithm and key is known to both parties, they can start using encryption. In this case, if someone starts sniffing, from this point onwards, the information is all secure. But if someone was there since beginning, he can get the key, as the initial negotiation takes place in the plain text. This is symmetric encryption. In symmetric encryption, the key used to encrypt and decrypt the information is the same. As the picture indicates, if we divide from middle, both halves are same, hence the name symmetric encryption. There is another type of encryption called asymmetric encryption, where these encryption and decryption keys are different, which are called public and private keys. Public and private are key pairs. Anything encrypted with public key can be decrypted by only the corresponding private key. And the reverse is also true. Anything encrypted with private key can be decrypted by only that corresponding public key. Let us take an example. Here, user A and B both have their public and private keys. A has some data it wants to send to B. To begin encryption, first A will request the public key of B and will encrypt the data using the user B's public key. On the receiving end, B will apply its own private key to decrypt the data. In this case, as the decryption key is not sent on the network, the process is much more secure than symmetric encryption. Similarly, B can obtain A's public key to encrypt and send the response back to A, which A can decrypt using its own private key. The concept and the process is all fine, but there is an issue with the performance. Asymmetric encryption is assumed to be 1000 times slower than symmetric encryption due to the complexity of mathematics involved in public-private key pair. For this reason, we are not able to use this method in real-time communication. So, does it mean that our real-time communication, for example VPN, is not secure? No, not at all. We have deployed some other method to take positives of both symmetric and asymmetric algorithms. So how we secure our real-time communication? Here is an example. A and B both have their corresponding public and private keys. First, they will exchange their public keys, will apply their own private keys as input to a calculation called Diffie-Hellman calculation, named after the name of the scientist who developed it. And you know what? That the output on both sides are same. This is taken as a shared secret. Shared secret means only these two parties know this value. As shared secret is a numeric value, it can be used as a key. But remember, the security for an encryption lies in frequent change of the encryption key. So instead of using the shared secret as encryption key, which is a unique fixed value as far as the same public-private key pair is in use, we apply some more logics and calculations to generate a symmetric encryption key, which can be changed over time. Finally, this symmetric key is used for encrypted communication. And this concept is called as Diffie-Hellman key exchange. Now, in case of SSL, when we have public-private key pair available only with server, let us see how it works. As the client opens a browser and requests access from the secure server, the server sends its public key to the client. As the client do not have a public key to offer, it generates a random key, encrypts it with server's public key, and sends it to the server. Applying its own private key, server decrypts the random key and establishes a temporary tunnel. The final key negotiation takes place using this temporary tunnel. And finally, a symmetric encryption tunnel is established for the data communication. Next is the concept of hash functions. Hash is an algorithm which can take any length of input but always produces the fixed length output. As input is numerous and output is limited, the uniqueness is not guaranteed, but it is not likely to happen frequently. Also, it is assumed that if data bits are modified, the hash output will change. Based on this assumption, the integrity of the data is verified. Hashing also has its significance in digital signing. In digital signatures, the hash of the message is calculated and encrypted with the private key of sender. As the private key is unique and is not shared with anybody, it guarantees that it is coming from the right source. On the receiving end, the receiver of the message obtains the public key of sender to decrypt the hash. Receiver also calculates fresh hash from the message and verifies that it should match. This way, both integrity and authenticity of the message is verified. So today we discussed about how symmetric encryption, asymmetric encryption, SSL, hash functions and digital signatures works. Hope it was informative for you.